Hey everybody, this is Michael again, and welcome back to my channel here on YouTube. Well guys, as the title says, it's time for another DVD and Blu-ray update. But before I begin, guys, let me say that we do have a MLK / KAEF Enterprises channel on Facebook. And basically what that page does is discuss films, and you get a heads up on what videos are coming out next, which videos I will be releasing on my YouTube page here. I'll put a link down there for you all to go check the page out and become a member if you'd like. You know, people, subscribers are free to post on the page and, you know, talk about movies that you like or whatever. But at any rate, it's just to give you a heads up basically on what film or what video is coming next that I will be discussing. Now, as you know, I'm doing B-Movie Mania, guys. I'm doing werewolf films. And I've actually watched the third werewolf film that I'm going to be spotlighting on on B-Movie Mania. And I haven't listed it on the Facebook page yet, but I will be doing that very, very soon. You know, I was just thinking, usually when I make a DVD update, that's when I kind of turn it into a vlog. I don't do vlogs very much at all, and I don't really know why, but I've never really been a vlog type person. There's a few on my channel, but usually I saved it for the DVD and Blu-ray updates. I don't know how that came into being, but it does. And everything's going good, guys. I'm doing very, very well. I don't like complaining. I don't like saying, you know, oh, I'm not doing too good, because, you know, I just kind of view it as, you know, there's a lot of people out in this world that are really suffering, and my life is in no comparison to some of the heartache and grief some people are going through, so I don't complain. I can remember being 5 or 6 years old and my grandmother telling me to count my blessings, because there's a lot of people out there that are really suffering. So I kind of took that to heart, and that's kind of how I deal with everyday life, guys. Yeah, sometimes I go through hardships and bad times and all that, just like everybody. But I try to keep it in the perspective and not get overcome in grief or anything like that, because my problems are significantly smaller than a lot of other people out there. And the people that are really hurting, my life is really no comparison to what some of them are going through. Still working on episode 2 of my fan film, Starship Valiant, guys. Hoping to film the first act of that in about 2 months. I've been putting it together. I'm going out of town this weekend to speak to a special makeup guy to do a couple of aliens for the film. And then I have to collaborate with another makeup artist here in town about some of the designs for one of the other aliens. Talked to an actress today, sent her the part that I would like her to play, and she accepted the role, so I'm happy about that. I've seen her work, and she does some really, really good things. And the film is moving along. It's a slow process, guys, and you know, with science fiction inherently, for the most part, especially Star Trek based fan films, it can be costly. So it's definitely going to be some out-of-pocket costs and involved in making the film, but in the meantime, it's been a really, really fun experience. When we made the first episode, Legacy, I never really expected it to have the following that it has had. A lot of people has really latched on to the film and enjoyed it, and it's become more enduring than I really expected it to be. A lot of people have really enjoyed the film, and for that I'm really appreciative. And you know, people really want to see another film involving these characters, so I'm working on that now, guys. First act done, still kind of developing the story, because we had a major setback. One of our cast members that was really had a pretty big part in the story got really, really sick, and she's not doing too well, and she's not going to be able to appear in the film. And she was really in the bulk of the story, so that's definitely going to require a total rewrite. And we're working on that. I say we, Craig and Brady and myself, trying to figure out the best way to go about this change in the story. But it's an ongoing thing, guys. Enjoying it. I tend to think of it as a hobby because I don't want to get so wrapped up into it to where it becomes an entity. I wanted to keep it just a hobby type kind of thing, a hobby kind of endeavor, so that, you know, we can have a fun time making this, because if it's not any fun, I don't want to do it. But anyway, that's where I am, guys. I'm doing well, can't complain. I know that I don't comment too much on YouTube anymore and things like that, but I am watching videos. Like I said, a lot of times I don't comment, but I am watching and I am seeing what you guys are doing. Sitting on the floor, guys, and it's like my foot is falling asleep. Wake up. You know that fall asleep feeling that you get? I hate that. Come on, wake up, foot, wake up. Oh, but anyway, we are going to begin the DVD and Blu-ray update. Now, guys, I've got some DVDs here and some Blu-rays. Now, I know it's been a while since I've actually done a DVD and Blu-ray update, but I don't really buy films like I used to, guys. What I usually do is just buy them, set them to the side, and when I get enough to actually warrant a DVD and Blu-ray update video, that's when I do it. And right now, I think I've got enough films to do that. But anyway, we're going to start with the DVDs first, then move on to the Blu-rays. But first film I have is one that I have not seen. I'm a fan of Clint Eastwood, and I'm really a fan of Clint Eastwood's Western movies. And I can remember seeing a lot of Eastwood's Western movies when I was a kid on late night television. And this is one of his, it's not new anymore. When did this come out? Does it say on here? Actually says, and I don't see a date. But I know it's in the 2000s, guys. This came out in the 2000s. This was actually considered one of his better films. Not just a Western, better Western, but one of his better films. And I have never seen it, but I've been wanting to see it for a long time, and I don't really know why I never got around to seeing it. But this is the two-disc collection, special edition of Unforgiven. And I don't know if you guys have seen this film. I'm sure some of you have. But I've only heard good things about this movie. As a matter of fact, Clint Eastwood has developed into quite a talented director. And the man is really, really busy. He's still making films. And this, like I said, is considered one of his best. And I am going to give this a look. And as a matter of fact, guys, this came from Best Buy. And I believe it was only like $3. I think they could have did a little bit better on the discs themselves, because there's no picture art or anything on them. Well, that one just fell out. We'll just snap it back in, guys. Okay. But yeah, we'll put that back. But that's Unforgiven. Next, we have a film that I seen a review of a long time ago. I like both of these actors. And you know, actually, guys, I can remember, I didn't see this in the theater, I've never seen it, but at the same time, I remember seeing the trailers for it, and I remember a Siskel and Ebert review of this film. I wanted to see it, but never got around to seeing it. And this is two of my favorite actors. I still enjoy these actors today. I think they're still very, very talented. But this is Chuck Norris and Louis Gossett Jr. in Firewalker. And like I said, guys, I never seen this, and I happened to come across it in Walmart. And it was pretty cheap. It may have been like $5, but I thought, wow, I got to get this because, you know, when will I see another release of this? So I picked it up, guys, and it just looked like it would be a fun movie. A pair of down-and-out fortune hunters cash in on high adventure. Even got a painted cover on it. How rare is that? But there's the back. I do believe that my buddy Rambo Raff for Life is a fan of this film, if I remember his review on it. Let me move my juice over here, guys. See if I can stretch out, because my leg is not apparently going to wake up. Maybe now. Are you waking up now? Please do. Trying to get comfortable with that. Okay. Next. There's another one that I've never seen. But I thought that it was a... Yeah. I picked this up at Walmart too because it was a documentary on video games. And I like video games, guys. As a matter of fact, I completed the video game Resident Evil Revelations 2. And now I'm playing a game called The Last of Us, which was a very, very popular game. And if I can get done tonight and not stay up too late, I'll record another episode of that. But this is a video game documentary entitled Video Games the Movie. And it's got a lot of my old school favorite video game characters, so I thought it would be a fun movie to watch. So, you know, I'm going to give this a shot, guys, and see how it is. It looks like a documentary on them. And, you know, I'm very, very interested in the old school video games. This has a really nice cover on it. Let's see. Mario, Q-Bert, Street Fighter, Sonic, Pac-Man, Halo, Dragon's Lair, Metal Gear Solid. Looks like Pitfall. What is her name? Lara Croft. Then that looks like... what was the name of this game? I'm trying to remember. You started out as a PC game. Was it World of Warcraft or something, I believe? Never got into that game, but I think that's what it was. But yeah, looks like that might be pretty interesting to watch. Next, we have a dollar store buy that I saw. It doesn't have a cover on it or anything. It's under their treasure hunt label. But this is a horror film that I seen a long time ago called Splinter. Matter of fact, I did a review of this a long time ago. I thought it was a... I remember liking the film. But, you know, for a dollar, I thought it was a decent buy for a dollar. And I'll end up taking it out of here and putting it in a case. Maybe printing off a DVD case for it so I can sit it on my shelf. But it's a decent horror film, guys. It's about these creatures. I don't know if it's... I believe the film kind of led to the creatures in this film coming from outer space. They were these splinter-type creatures with spikes. Kind of like a porcupine without the animal. Just the quills. And they were like growing in the bodies of people and just like making them, you know, quills coming out of them and infecting them and all that. Pretty unique film, guys, if I do recall. I'd like to see it again. Okay. Next. This was another dollar store buy. On sale for about $3. And I picked it up. Its tagline says, "Upset the head and you're dead." A lot of guys say that, don't they? No. But this is Head of the Family. And it almost reminds me of Basket Case. You guys remember that film, Basket Case? But you have a guy here with a big head. But unlike Basket Case, he has legs and arms. You know, they probably don't work, but he has them. Well, the arms look like they might work, but not the head. But this is a Full Moon film. I think Full Moon, back in the day when they were making movies, they really made some fun, kind of off-the-wall movies. I kind of miss Full Moon. And here's the back of it, guys. There you go. You can pick that up there. The front looks pretty cool, guys. The front is actually a painting. And that does look pretty cool. Who actually played the main character in this? Let's see. Well, I mean, I get the characters' names, but I don't know who actually played the head character. But anyway, looking forward to seeing this, guys, just for the fun factor and the cheesiness in it. Okay, my leg is trying to go to sleep again, guys. But next we have a film that I bought solely because there's 10 minutes of Willis O'Brien animation in it that I had never seen and I just wanted to see it. Now, Willis O'Brien is the special effects genius behind the original King Kong film. He kind of was the pioneer of early stop motion. As a matter of fact, I believe he did the silent film The Lost World, I believe. But I've always liked the old stop motion dinosaur animation. I just, you know, as a kid, I just ate that stuff up, loved it to death. As a matter of fact, late nights when I was a kid and a dinosaur film would come on with stop motion and all that, oh man, you couldn't get me to bed. But this is actually a sort of a documentary that discusses the animal kingdom, and the Willis O'Brien's animation was put in as the documentary went back and talked about prehistoric life. But this is the animal world. And this is actually one of those made-on-demand DVD-Rs put out by Warner Brothers. You order it and then they make it. They don't keep them in stock. But it was the only way to get it. And I'm quite satisfied to have it, guys, because I think it looks very, very professional. It looks like a real DVD. Even on the inside, it has a nice cover, even though there's no picture on the cover itself. But this is one I'm looking forward to watching, guys, for sure. As a matter of fact, let me put these up here on my table, guys. Yeah, like this. Yeah, they're in camera. Okay. Next, we have one that I've heard quite a few good things about. Now, I could have bought the Blu-ray of this, but I didn't want to. I wanted to buy the DVD just to see if I enjoyed the film or not. And some people liked it, and a lot of people were not so kind to it. But for the most part, from what I've seen, a lot of people did like this film. But this is Interstellar. And I have yet to see this, guys. If you follow me at all on my channel here on YouTube, you know that I'm a huge science fiction fan. And I love sci-fi, so hopefully Interstellar will be a movie that is very enjoyable. You know, I'm not a fan really too much of Matthew McConaughey. He's the star of this. And just for some reason, I think he's all right. I don't hate him. I really don't hate any actors, but it's just something about him. I don't know. It's just kind of hard to take him seriously sometimes. If I remember correctly, though, Matthew McConaughey did a film called A Time to Kill. I believe he played a lawyer in that film, and he was defending Samuel L. Jackson, who killed these two guys that killed him, or that beat and raped his daughter. And I believe Matthew McConaughey was his lawyer in that film, and I thought he was perfect in that movie. Okay. Next, guys, we have a film that is basically a remake of the, the film has been made back in the 70s, so I wouldn't really call this a remake. I would just call it a remake of the novel that the original film was based on. And I bought it simply because I'm such a huge fan of the original film. I love the original film that has Peter Cushing and Doug McClure in it. Peter Cushing and Doug McClure, totally great in that film, totally charming. Love the original The Land That Time Forgot. And this is a new version of the film, or the new remake of that book, both based on the book, The Land That Time Forgot. Now, I know for sure that I probably will not like this as much as I like the original film, simply for the fact that I love Peter Cushing and Doug McClure. And there is a Mark McClure, guys. I keep wanting to say Mark McClure, but it was Doug McClure. Here's the back of it. And I was a little bit leery about this one, guys, because, you know, I've been seeing a lot of great DVD covers featuring dinosaurs. And then I'll go online or on YouTube and listen to reviews of these films, and I'll talk about how cheesy the special effects are, or how the dinosaurs are only in, like, the last act of the film. And I don't want to get burned by that stuff, guys. If I want to buy a dinosaur film, I want to buy it because of the dinosaurs are in it. But I've heard some good things about this one. And even on Amazon, people were talking about how, you know, pretty much it's a fun film. Now, when they put on here in the back of this, a creature-filled classic adventure in the tradition of Jurassic Park and King Kong, and it's put out by the Asylum, it's like, yeah, because this is a film by the Asylum. But at the same time, I'm very, very leery about Asylum film productions, but this one actually got good reviews, and a lot of people say this is their best film. And I'm definitely going to give it a shot. As long as it's not a Sharknado. Okay, next we have another film, guys, based upon dinosaurs, and I never got to see this one, and I really didn't want to get the Blu-ray of it, because as much as I love dinosaurs, you know, I don't really want a bad dinosaur film, and, well, I'm just going to show you the name. It's Walking with Dinosaurs, the movie, and this is more or less probably a film for kids, which, you know, I'm a kid at heart, so that's fine. I remember when this came out, it didn't really get great reviews, and I was such a fan of the original Walking with Dinosaurs documentary series, about one of the greatest documentaries on dinosaurs, that I thought when this was advertised, I just thought, wow, Walking with Dinosaurs, how can they go wrong? I'm such a fan of that series. But they made it into a animated children's film, and I'm definitely going to give it a look, guys. And hopefully it'll be good. I'm sure that there'll be things about it that I'll like, and I don't think I'll dislike it at all, really. I really don't, but I wanted to get the DVD, and if it's really, really good, I'll get the pick up the Blu-ray and give that to one of the kids in the family. You know what I just realized, guys? I've been recording now for 21 minutes and the camera has not turned off. Usually, remember when I used to make these, my motion picture collection, and the camera would cut off like at 16 minutes? I don't know why it's still going, but I'm only at 1280 though. Maybe that's why, because usually I got it at 19. But anyway, next we have a couple of older films. This is one that I picked up because I was kind of intrigued by it. I thought it had a pretty neat premise. It's definitely a film based upon its time when it was made. Does this actually have a date on when it was released? I know it's in black and white, and I believe it came out in the 50s. But this is Red Planet Mars. And this actually has Peter Graves in it, guys. I like Peter Graves. And I say that it's a product of its time because on the back it says, oh, well, guys, I was just talking about how the camera didn't cut off at 16 minutes and then it cut off. But anyway, I was showing you guys Red Planet Mars. And there's a very, very young Peter Graves there, guys. I thought the premise of this film sounded interesting. As a matter of fact, on the back, guys, it says, an American scientist contacts Mars by radio and receives information that Mars is a utopia and that Earth's people can be saved if they return to the worship of God. Revolution sweeps the Earth, including the Soviet Union, but there remains doubt about the messages being genuine, as an ex-Nazi claims he was duping the Americans. But that is Red Planet Mars, and definitely sounds interesting, guys. Got to give it a shot. Next, we have another film that I may have just seen a few clips from when I was a kid. I always wanted to see this film, never got to see it. And from what I've read about the film in its heyday, it was a pretty spectacular movie. Kind of light on story, but visually, crowds really were captivated by it back in the day. This doesn't have a release date on it, guys. It just has a DVD production date on it, 2006, but I believe this came out in the 50s, maybe the late 50s. But this is This Island Earth, and one of the really captivating scenes that I remember from it, or characters, is this creature on the back that I thought was just totally cool, totally neat looking. And let's take it out, and they did a great job on the disc too, guys. You know, it's better than just a plain old disc, but This Island Earth, definitely looking forward to watching that, guys. Next, we have one that I remember from the 70s. I remember being very, very young and seeing this trailer advertised. I don't know exactly what year this came out. You know, none of these. Okay, this one says it came out in 1976. And this was by the same guy, director William Girdler, follows up his 1976 hit film Grizzly with this insane, ego-sensitive, nature runs amok thrill ride. And Leslie Nielsen is the star. And the tagline reads, "For centuries, they were hunted for bounty, fun, and food. Now it's their turn." This is Day of the Animals. And that is a painted cover there, guys. Pretty doggone impressive, pretty neat cover. And here's the back, which is equally pretty cool, I think. Have not seen this, guys. I don't know. I like animals running amok films, and I like Leslie Nielsen, so hopefully it'll be a film that's enjoyable. Okay, now we're on to some TV DVDs. These are DVDs of television shows that I am collecting, guys. The first one is a series that was based on dinosaurs. I actually used to watch this on television. It was canceled pretty doggone quick. It only had one season, 13 episodes. Now, it was stopped in the middle, guys. And some of you might ask, why buy a series of films or episodes where they didn't finish the series? Well, it has my favorite subject in it, dinosaurs. And it has some very, very impressive dinosaur effects. And that's really why I snagged this up, because I like dinosaurs. But this is the complete series of Terra Nova. And I thought it was a good concept. I enjoyed the show while it was on, but unfortunately, like I said, it didn't last. And here's the back of it, guys. 13 episodes of this series here. And some nice special features. I bought it a lot. Also, too, because of the special features. This was actually, I believe, produced by Steven Spielberg. Does it have his name on here? I could have swore that Spielberg was associated with this for some reason. But it had kind of like a nice little twist to it, guys. In this series, the Earth of the future was becoming uninhabitable. And they were sending people back to the past to survive. So a select few people were going back to the dinosaur days, and Terra Nova was the base that was established there. And this came out in 2011. It's been a while since I saw it, so I may be a little shaky on the details, but I enjoyed it, guys. Here's the inside of it. Looks pretty nice in my humble opinion. Even the discs are pretty nice. They're all different. They got different dinosaurs on them. You see that one there. And then you have these two. And then you finally, that's the same? No, that's a different dinosaur there. There's the back cover. But a decent show, guys. Kind of sad that it went off the air, but it was a really decent show. And it had this guy here is the same guy that played the military commander in Avatar, and he also played in the new Conan film. And some really, really decent special features, guys. You got deleted scenes, director's diaries, making the pilot, occupation, resistance, extended episode, mysteries explored, Cretaceous life, the dinosaurs of Terra Nova, audio commentary. This was written by Brana Braga. He's also one of the writers of Star Trek The Next Generation and Star Trek Deep Space Nine. So I'm glad to have Terra Nova in my collection, guys. Very, very glad. Okay. Let's see if I can shift a little bit here before my leg goes to sleep. But this is a series that came out in the 70s. I remember, I think it was the 70s anyway. It might have been a little bit later. Okay, came out in 1974. And The only thing I remembered about this television series was the opening movie. I believe I watched this show, but I don't remember much about the show, the episodes. But the main movie, when it was released, I remember that. And I remember what sticks out in my mind is a scene where, these people are in this little cabin, it's dark, and there's wolves circling their cabin. But that's basically all I remember. I just bought this for nostalgia's sake, and I thought I'd give it a watch. And I only bought season one. If I like the show, I'm going to move on and get other seasons. But this is Little House on the Prairie. And like I said, guys, I'm going to watch this, and if I really get into it, I'm going to pick up the other seasons. But I thought I'd give it a shot just to see how it is after all these years. The funny thing about westerns, it's that they can never seem old because they're already old. So, next, this is a series that I love. I love this series. When I watched it originally, didn't miss an episode. But I think that I have this collection this season because originally when I bought this, I wanted to get season 3 and 4. But when I got home, I had season 2, and I think I already have season 2 of this. But this is the $6 Million Man. And I really, really believe I have this. And if I do, I'm not going to open it. I'm going to take it back and swap it out because I got it from Walmart. And, they'll let you return it. But I love the $6 Million Man. I think it's a great show. But I did pick up season 4 of it. And it's apparently they made a lot more episodes than they did in the regular volumes, because if you look at these, this one's way, season 4 here is way thicker than the other one, guys. So must be a lot more episodes. This one says season 2. How many episodes do they say in this? And it is not, well, it doesn't say how many episodes. Okay, 22 episodes in this one. And on the back of this one, it says 22 episodes. But it's got some exclusive bonus features on it, so maybe that's why it's so much thicker. Complete season 4. But anyway, $6 Million Man, for those of you that may have been too young to catch this show, dealt with a astronaut who had an accident. He was going up into space and his or Earth orbit, and his ship crash landed, and he lost his legs and his arm and his eye, and he had to be basically, he's a cyborg. They rebuilt him. So that's basically what the $6 Million Man is. And I really enjoyed the show. I remember this show was really, really popular when it came out, guys. A lot of people love this show, and I had a good time with the $6 Million Man. Really enjoyed it. Of course, if they made it today, it would probably be the $6 Billion Man. But anyway, next I have a couple of box sets, guys. The first one is of a program that I watched as a kid. Actually loved this show as a kid. One of my favorites. Definitely a lot of nostalgic value with this show. I love these shorts. They're black and white shorts that were created probably in the 30s and 40s. But, like the Three Stooges, this one has really been endeared upon me, and I just really, really love it. And the chance came, I got an email from Amazon, and this was on sale, and it was a complete collection of this entire classic series. I just had to pick it up, and I don't remember how much I paid for it because it's been sitting on my shelf for a while now, waiting to show off. But this is the original 80 theatrical shorts of The Little Rascals. And this is the actual Hal Roach version of the Little Rascals, not the new films or any of that. I didn't even watch the new films because they couldn't hold a candle to this. As a matter of fact, guys, even to this day, I've got the complete collection of the Three Stooges, and I have never watched the new film yet. Just no desire. But this is a really nice cover too. Look at that. That looks pretty doggone good. But this is a complete set of the Little Rascals. Really, really happy to have this, guys. Really, really happy. I'll have to do a box set review. I haven't done a box set review in like forever, but I'll have to do one and show this off, guys. But I'll show it to you a little bit here. There's the inside, and then it folds out. It folds out quite a bit, actually. There we go. So it's quite a collection there, guys. Quite a collection. And I'm just like really, really happy to have this. I have not seen the Little Rascals in like forever. And I'm looking forward to watching this. Actually, it says 1929 to 1938. This collection contains all 80 of the original The Little Rascals theatrical talkies in their entirety. This amazing 8-disc set contains a collectible booklet, loads of nostalgic bonus features, photos, and much more. This preeminent collection is a must-have for fans both old and new. And I would definitely agree. I think I got this whole thing for like $30, something like that. But very, very glad to have it in my collection. Now, here's another box set, a Blu-ray set this time, guys, that I'm very, very happy to have. I've seen very, very few of this man's films, but this Essential Collection has several films in it, probably his most well-known films, and I definitely want to watch these. But this is the limited edition Alfred Hitchcock, The Essentials Collection on Blu-ray. And I am looking forward to seeing these classic films. Matter of fact, guys, the only one that I've seen is Psycho and The Birds. But The Birds, I don't think I've ever seen it in its entirety. And Psycho, I don't think I've ever seen it in its entirety. So it's really going to be really, really great to watch these films, guys. Not to mention Rear Window, Vertigo, and North by Northwest. I'm looking forward to watching all of these. There's the back of it. Really, really great collection of films here, guys. And I'm really so happy to have it. I'll just open it up for a second and show you guys right quick. This one deserves another box set review. There we go. Let's open it up a little wider. This one spreads way, way out too. I probably won't be able to show it all, guys. But yeah, there's the one for The Birds. Wouldn't mind having a big poster of that. I like the way that looks. Let's fold it back up. We'll go in depth on that one day. Got to bring back box set reviews, guys. Those were pretty popular videos, and I used to make those. Okay, let me stretch out again. The old leg is going to sleep again. Okay. I've got four more to show you guys. My Kool-Aid is getting a little waterlogged. But next, we have a film by Arnold Schwarzenegger. And I actually got a review up of this film on my channel, guys. I have reviewed it. And I did enjoy the film. If you want to go watch the video and get my actual thoughts of the film, you can. But this is the Blu-ray of Maggie. And like I said, guys, this is Schwarzenegger's film where he plays the father of Abigail Breslin, who has contracted a virus that is slowly turning her into a zombie. And here's the back of it. I think I got this for $14.99 at Best Buy. Yeah, when it first came out. Because I'd heard about the film and just wanted to see it. I knew I wouldn't hate the film. Plus, I'm a Schwarzenegger fan, so there you go. Okay, next we have a film that I actually have this on DVD in a really, really nice collectible set, but I didn't have it on Blu-ray, and I wanted it on Blu-ray. Time's running out. Well, apparently you could tell I got cut off again, guys. Battery went back down. But anyway, this is one that I wanted on Blu-ray. I'm a really big fan of the original film. And I'm still glad that I have the DVD set of this film because it has some really, really nice special features on it that I'm not so sure are all on this Blu-ray. But this is the classic film, The Reanimator, on Blu-ray. And I got this pretty cheap, guys. I think it was only like $4.99 or maybe even $4 on Amazon plus shipping. But here's the back of it. It has a lot of bonus features on it, guys. Here in this little box here, it still has a ton of bonus features. There's a picture there. But I enjoyed The Reanimator. I thought it was a really, really enjoyable film. Just a lot of fun. Ingenious. It has as much originality as it has gore. And that's really saying something. The New York Times. So yeah, this was a fun film to watch. Glad to have it in my collection. I also want to get From Beyond. I don't have that on Blu-ray yet, but it's one that I'm looking to get. It's one of my favorite films also. Just to mention, guys, Jeffrey Combs, there's not a good picture of him on the back there, but he plays a lead scientist in this film. Really, really good actor. Definitely a underrated actor. He deserves so much recognition because he's really a damn fine actor. You can see some of his best work on Star Trek Deep Space Nine, where he's just great on that show. Just simply great. Okay, guys. Next, we have a double Blu-ray collectible set of two films that I have not seen in like forever. But definitely films that I want to watch again. I was a big fan of the first one. I actually saw the first one in the theater. Actually, I saw them both in the theater. You know, I wasn't so big a fan of the sequel, but I did enjoy the original film. And I want to revisit these films again to see what I think about them. But this is the media book collection of Ghostbusters 1 and Ghostbusters 2 on Blu-ray. Here's the back. Really, really nice picture there, guys. And inside, media book, because you do get a collectible booklet with the films. There's some information on the making of the movie. There we go. This is deserving of a video all by itself. But I've always liked this picture here. But at any rate, guys, definitely glad to have this in my collection. Like I said, I don't believe I've seen Ghostbusters since I saw it at the theater, either one of these films, again. So it's going to be really fun to revisit these movies. And that set there, guys, I believe it's pretty cheap on Amazon, maybe like I think I got it for like maybe $8, $9. Okay, next we have a film that I was interested in seeing. Never got around to see it when it came out of the theater. As a matter of fact, I believe this came out in 2014. Did it come out in 2014? Well, if it did, guys, I don't see the year it was made on here. Oh, 2013, according to this. But I never got to see it. It kind of got mixed reviews, but I wanted to see it. Found this at Best Buy, pretty cheap. I think it was like $7.99, and decided I would give it a look. But this is the Blu-ray and DVD copy of Ender's Game. And like I said, guys, wasn't really received too well. Matter of fact, it didn't make that much money. But I want to give it a shot and see what I think of it. Here's the back of it. Really great covers for both of them, though. I really like the covers of this. 2013, guys. Harrison Ford looks awfully good on this cover, considering how old he is there. He looks really, really good. But I'm going to give it a shot, guys. See how it is. Haven't even opened it yet. Same cover on the back, yeah. And finally, guys, one more film. Picked this up at 7-Eleven. I did like the movie. And I hear that there's another cut of this film. A good friend of mine was telling me that there's another cut of this film. But I did enjoy this movie, guys. Had some fun with it. But found it at 7-Eleven for $4.99. And this is X-Men Days of Future Past. And like I said, I did enjoy this. I think it was probably one of my favorite X-Men movies, that's for sure. And it has a neat looking cover on it as well. Here's the back. And yeah, there's my sticker price there, guys, if it shows. $4.99. But haven't opened it yet, but gonna give it a shot. There's also, I hear, a cut called the Rogue Edition that actually has Rogue in the film, so that's gonna be interesting to watch because she was not in the original movie here. But anyway, guys, there you have it. That's my DVD and Blu-ray update. It's become a mountain now. If you hear banging out there, guys, it's road construction. They're actually doing road construction this time of night. I think it's like, what? Well, I don't have a clock near me, but I would guess it's about 11 at night now, and they're still doing road collections. Yeah, I collect roads. They're still doing road construction work. And I am getting ready to turn on my laptop over here, guys, because I'm going to be editing this video tonight and hopefully uploading it tonight, or at least encoding it tonight. But anyway, there you have it, guys. Hope you enjoyed. I will see you in the next video, where once again I'll be returning to the werewolf movies. Thanks for watching, everybody, and I'll see you in the next video.